Yes, dear students, in this video we are going to discuss the topic Protozoans, chapter number 3, Microorganisms, class 8. Now, they are traditionally looked upon as animals because most protozoans are animal-like. Animal-like means they do not possess cell wall and also they do not perform the process of photosynthesis. Even protozoans like Euglena contain cell wall and they photosynthesize. It means it is an exception. Euglena is a protozoa which is a connecting link between plants and animals because it looks like animal, it has some life processes like animals, but it also photosynthesize and also contain cell wall. Generally, the protozoans are saprophytic or parasitic. Saprophytic means they feed on dead and decaying substances, and parasitic means they feed on the living host. Some live in fresh water, some live in salt water, and some live in the soil. It means in most of the habitats we can find protozoans. Many lives inside the body of plants and animals, as I have already told that they are parasitic. They reproduce by the process of binary fission. It is a process in which a single organism get divided into two daughter organisms. Example, amoeba, paramecium, etc. Now come to useful protozoans. They serve as food for many small aquatic organisms. Second, they are ultimate decomposers and are useful in the treatment of sewage. Third, termites have protozoans living in their body and helps to digest the cellulose in the wood eaten by the termites. You all know, children, termites, they are the small animals which feed on wood. So you all know that wood has the cells, plant cells, which have cell wall made up of cellulose. So in order to digest that cellulose, some protozoans live in the gut of the termite, which helps to digest cellulose. Now come to harmful protozoans. They causes diseases, that is amoebic dysentery is caused by a protozoa called as Entamoeba histolytica. Second one, giardiasis is caused by the protozoa giardia. Third one, malaria is caused by Plasmodium. Children, there are four types of Plasmodium. Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium malariae, and Plasmodium ovale. So they cause four different types of malaria. Next is sleeping sickness. It is caused by the protozoan Trypanosoma gambiens or Trypanosoma palladium. And the vector of the Trypanosoma is Tsetse fly. Okay, dear students, thank you very much.